What's in a voice? More than you might think. By analyzing the ways charismatic public speakers rouse and influence large audiences, scientists have increasing evidence that the voice can be an instrument of great persuasive power. But is this a skill we can all learn? Here to tell us more is WSJ senior science correspondent Robert Lee Hotz. Robert Lee, thanks so much for being with us today. Tell us first, what are the characteristics of a great voice? What makes a voice persuasive?
Well, now there's music in every human voice, but some people, either innately or through training, have a unique ability to inspire trust, to dominate, to influence large groups of people. And experts in voice perception at the University of California in Los Angeles have identified the pitch, the frequency, the cadences, the tones and timbres of what they call the charismatic voice. Now, these are the voices of political leaders who have a unique capacity to sway large groups of voters, to put across their ideas, across their messages. And they are finding the key patterns that run across different languages, almost like it's a universal set of power chords, if you like.
So powerful politicians in countries around the world often share certain characteristics in their voices.
Yes. I mean, some of this is biological.
Sure.
I mean, it's innate. It's crafted by evolution from, I don't know, monkey calls. But it's also cultural. Different cultures have different preferences, of course, for leadership style. Some mm-hmm. groups like to be dominated. Some want to be persuaded. But what they found was across all of those variables, there was a certain set of characteristics, and maybe a good example is as follows. They were looking at political leaders in Italy, in France, in Brazil, and to make sure that meaning did not get in the way of analyzing how influential the sound of a voice was, they used a special speech synthesizer technique to smooth out the words so that you weren't actually hearing the ideas. And in some of the experiments, they actually had the languages, the speakers, rated by people who didn't speak the language they were speaking. So they were just responding to the tones. And one characteristic thing they found is that, well, okay, we, I think, intuitively know that people with deep voices, we hear them as being dominant and large, even if we can't see them. And people with higher voices we see as being small and submissive. And they found that these charismatic political leaders all had in common a capacity for extreme ranges in frequency. I mean, almost like an opera singer. They really went to the highs. They really went to the lows. And that this, you know, in some unconscious, intuitive, nonverbal signal-to-noise kind of way, did something special in the perceptions of the people who were listening.
So there was music to it, almost.
There is definitely music to it.
And so are these great voices, are they born or can they be made?
Well, I think it's certainly the case that we all know of political leaders or business leaders, product pitch people who have a natural gift, you know, that game show voice.
Sure.
But also there are things they tell me that you can learn. And mm-hmm. and in I'm sure voice coaches get at this kind of thing when they're teaching public speaking, but in particular, they're talking about this ability to really use the full range of your voice.
Now, there are prominent business leaders here in the U.S. who voice experts point to as either having excellent voices or maybe not so great voices. So we have a clip that we're going to play.
We're going to talk about getting married later this week, so we'll see. Did Jack leave?
No, he's still here.
And so I have the utmost respect for Jack.
So what's the real story underneath Prime? Well, it's patience, persistence, and attention to the smallest of details.
Now, that short clip showed a little bit of Tim Cook and Jeff Bezos, and experts say that Tim Cook has a charismatic voice. Why is that?
Yes, these actually are good examples, and it's fair to note that clearly Tim Cook and Jeff Bezos are both highly successful businessmen
sure.
who don't completely rely on the qualities of their voice to get ahead. But if you can recall how Jeff Bezos was talking, and it was public speaking now we're talking about, a kind of oratory. He's talking to a crowd, and his voice actually was rather flat, almost monotonous. It was all down in the same register. And the clip of Tim Cook, even though it was staged as a kind of conversation, you know, he had a chair and everything, but he was using a public speaking voice, and it hit much more of the register.
Yes.
And there was much more variety to it. And he occupied his vocal space differently. Now, this is something that's still under investigation.
Sure.
So there's no hard formula.
It's fascinating, though. Let me ask you, is there a difference between an authoritative female voice and a male one?
Well, see, that's a great question, because all of this research, unfortunately, up to now has been done with male voices. And they are the researchers at UCLA are just now starting to collect vocal samples of female leaders so that they can subject them to the same kind of voice perceptual analysis to find out, like, what is the power voice for a woman? Because it's almost certainly the case that there is one, and that it's no doubt distinctively different from a male's.
All right, well, we're going to invite you back to talk about that when that research is done, Lee. Thank you so much for that.